Hello students, hope you all are doing good. Well, in the previous video, we learned how to find the inverse of a 2x2 matrix using elementary row transformation or column transformations. Now, today's topic is to find the inverse of a matrix using elementary transformation. It can be row, it can be column, but of 3x3 matrix. In previous video, we did of 2x2 matrix. Now we are doing of 3x3 matrix. Now taking a question. If A is a 3x3 matrix, it's 2, 0, minus 1, 5, 1, 0, 0, 1, 3. So find A inverse using elementary row transformations. Now, in previous video, we learned that A is equals to IA, because whenever a matrix is multiplied with the identity matrix, we get the same matrix. So here A is 2, 5, 0, 0, 1, 1, minus 1, 0, 3. And your identity matrix, whose diagonal elements are 1. Of course, here A is of 3x3 matrix. So we have to take identity matrix of order 3x3. So if the diagonal elements are 1, 1, 1, then rest of are 0 into A. Now, we have to make this matrix into identity matrix. And automatically the changes will occur in this matrix. If we'll take any operation on this matrix, then automatically the changes will occur on this matrix and this will become A inverse. Yesterday we did the same question, but that was of 2x2 matrix, but now it is of 3x3 matrix. So automatically changes will occur. So now we'll operate on first row. So we'll follow the rule. First of all, we'll follow the rule. We'll change the very first column into 1, 0, 0. This is the very first rule, that we have to change the very first column. That means we have to change 2 into 1, 5 into 0, and of course 0 is already here, so we don't need to change it. So we'll change the very first column, then we'll proceed to the next column. So first of all, we'll operate on R1. Of course, here is 2, we have to change it into the 1, so we'll divide it by 2. Whenever we have to divide the row 1, that means another 2 rows will become same. It is 5, 1, 0, 0, 1, 3, it's 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. There will be no change in row 2nd and row 3rd. So whenever 2 will divide by 2, it becomes 1. 0 divided by 2 is 0, and minus 1 divided by 2 is minus 1 by 2. Now, here we have to divide by 2. 1 divided by 2 is 1 by 2. 0 divided by 2 is 0. 0 divided by 2 is 0. Now the changes. Now the row first has changed already. It is 1, 0, minus 1 by 2. And here it is 1 by 2, 0, 0. Now what we'll do next is 0. We need 0 here instead of 5. Now we'll operate on R2 minus, we'll use this 1 to become its 0. To attain this 5 number, to change this number into 0, we have to use this 1. So if we'll multiply 5 ones of 5, if we'll multiply with 5, then it becomes 5, then 5 minus 5 is 0. So what will be the operation here? R2 minus 5 R1. So of course R2 will change. So R1 and R3, that means row 1st and row 3rd, will become same. It is 0, 0, 1. Now what will be the change? R2 is here 5 minus 5 R1. 5 ones are 5. Again, R2 is 1 minus 5 into R1. 5 into 0, 0. Then R2 is 0 minus, minus minus plus 5 into 1 by 2. It is 5 by 2. Again, R2 is 0 minus 5 into R1, which is 5 by 2. Then 1 minus 5 into R1, 5 into 0, 0. Then R2, 0 minus 5 into R1, 5 zeros is a 0. Then the changes will already occur in the second row. 5 minus 5 is 0, 1 minus 0 is 1, 0 plus 5 by 2 is 5 by 2. You are watching that second row has already changed. It was 510, but now it is 015 by 2. And 100% changes will occur here as well. It is now minus 5 by 2, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1 into A. Now, what you have seen here, that it is already 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1. The first column has already completed. First, we need to change the first column into 1, 0, 0. It has already changed. Now, the second column, we want 0, 1, 0. Here it is 0, already 0. Here it is already 1. But this element we need to change into the 0. As per identity element, second column is 0, 1, 0. So here it is 0, here it is 1. But we need to change this element into 0. Now we'll operate on R3, that means row third. What we'll do? R3, if we'll subtract 1 minus 1, if we'll do 1 minus 1, it becomes 0. So R3 minus R2. So row 3 will change. So then first and second row will remain as it is. 0, 1, 5 by 2. So R3 minus R2. 0 minus 0 is 0. 1 minus 1, 0. 3 minus 5 by 2. It is 6 minus 5, which is 1 by 2. After taking LCM, it becomes 1 by 2. Then R3 minus R2. 0 minus of minus means plus 5 by 2. 0 minus 1 is minus 1. 1 minus 0 is 1. So it is 5 by 2 minus 1, 1. Now, second row has already changed. Second column has already changed. First column has already changed. Now, we'll strike on the third column. We'll change into 0, 0, 1. The third column is 0, 0, 1. That means the very first element will change here. It should be changed into the 1. Now, if 1 by 2 is there, if we'll multiply with 2, it becomes 1. So, operation on third row, 2 into R3. So, operation on third row, that means the first and second rows will become same. 0, 1, 5 by 2, 1 by 2, 0, 0, 5 by 2, 1, 0. First and second row will remain as it is. Now, we'll multiply with 2. 2 zeros are 0, 2 zeros are 0. 2 into 1 by 2 is 1. Now, 5 by 2 into 2 is 5. Minus 1 into 2 is minus 2. And 1 into 2 is 2. Now, it is already 1 now. Now, we need to change 5 by 2 into 0 and minus 1 by 2 into 0. Now, we'll operate on second row. R2 minus, here it is 5 by 2. We need 0 here. So, what will you will use 1. We'll multiply with 5 by 2. 5 by 2 into 1, 5 by 2. And then we'll subtract, we'll get 0. R3, 5 by 2 into R3. That means operation on R2 is R2 minus 5 by 2, R3. The first and second row will remain as it is. 0, 1, 5 by 2, 1 by 2, 0, 0, minus 5 by 2, 1, 0 into A. What was the operation? It was R2 minus 5 by 2 R3. It was R2. What is R2 here? Oh, we need to change the second row. Sorry, we are going to operate on second row. So the second row will change. Third row will remain as it is. So second row R2 0 minus 5 by 2 into R3, which is again 0. Now 1 minus 5 by 2 into 0. 5 by 2 minus 5 by 2. Again minus 5 by 2 minus 5 by 2 into R3. That means minus 5, 5 is 25. 25 by 2. 1 minus minus plus 5 by 2 into 2 is 5. Then 0 minus 5 by 2 into 2 is 5. So it becomes 1, 0 minus 1 by 2. 0 minus 0 is 0. 1 minus 5 by 2 into 0, 0. It becomes 1. 5 by 2 minus 5 by 2, it is 0. 0, 0, 1. 1 by 2, 0, 0. It becomes minus 30 by 2. Minus 30 by 2 is your 50, minus 15. It is 6. It is minus 5, 5. Minus 2, 2. Now, what are you watching now? First column has changed, second column has changed, third column we need 0, 0, 1. Here it is 0, here it is 1. We need to change the very first element. So it is minus 1 by 2. We need to add 1 by 2 so that it becomes 0. What we'll do? We'll operate on R1. R1 plus 1 by 2 R3. Because here it is 1, we'll multiply with 1 by 2, then it becomes 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2. It is 0. 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. Because 1 plus 0 is 1. 0 plus 0 is 0. Minus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 into 1, it is 0. So it becomes identity matrix. Now the changes on R1. First of all, we'll write second and third row. So changes R1. It is 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 into 5, which is 5 by 2. Again, 0 plus minus minus 1 by 2 into 2, which is 1. Again, R1 is 0 plus 1 by 2 into 2, which is 1. So here it is, identity matrix. Five plus one, six. Six divided by two is three. Minus one, one. Minus 15, six. Minus five, five. Minus two, two. Into A. If this is your identity matrix, then it automatically, if it is your A, then it is your A inverse. So A inverse is three minus 15, five. Minus one, six. Minus two. 1 minus 5, 2. So it is again of 3 by 3 matrix. So in the same manner, you can find A inverse by using elementary column operations. But the restriction is only the restriction is that if you are starting the question by column operation, then you have to operate. That means you have to do each and every operation on columns. Instead of rows, you have to take in columns. You cannot switch from rows to column and from columns to rows in between the question. Hope you understand this lecture. I'm sending you one assignment. So please do it. And if you have any problem, you can contact me in between 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. Thank you so much.